I gotta clear my conscience, man. Tell you how I'm really feeling, you know? And another one. Torch. To see a smile is worth it to me. Ain't nobody perfect, but shorty perfect to me. Torch.
I hope you know that, girl, you mean the world to me. You hold first place in my eyes. Damn it, let me speak on. Baby, baby, you are.
Alright, we're back, y'all. So, yeah, this is the DLC for the game. Walls Be Together. So I guess this is just a continuation of the main game. I guess it's a continuation of the main game. And from what I've seen of the less players who, like, I didn't look at the video for it. What I'm saying is, what I've seen, like, the length, as far as length, it seems like this is only going to be, like, maybe an hour. So maybe, like, two episodes. If it ends up being like only an hour though, I might just compound it to like one. But it ends up being longer though, I'll probably just I'll probably just compound it or whatever. Anyway, with that, let's get this cracking.
So, it's been this long, huh?
Oh wait, no. I don't think they let me keep the dollar sign. Wait, did they? Hold on, let me try real quick. Dollar sign. Yep, they did. You only away for a week. How's your trip? Her eyes darted upwards to match my own, filled with the typical aura of hesitance. Still, I have to give her some credit. She isn't blushing. After all, this is the girl I fell in love with. By now, it should be expected that I know all of her special quirks. The thing that makes her carry...
It was good. Thank you.
There's no need to be shy. We are dating, but she really hasn't changed. Her hair, gently swaying in the urban breeze, still flows gracefully down her shoulders like a stream, each golden strand glistening in the sunlight. A charming aspect, I can say the least. Maybe now, with all our problems behind us, we can bring on a new feeling to our everyday lives.
It's just...
Hold on, I'm gonna turn this down a little bit. Yo, why does it seem like she always more quiet than... Okay, there we go. Alright, that should be loud enough. For whatever reason, I swear.
I missed you.
Shout on her words. Carrie shifts the vision quickly to the side, avoiding my now bemused gaze. I'm pretty sure she grabbed the attention from a few passerbys, too. Despite it being pretty, letting her hair stand there nuzzled in the cold autumn breeze would be wrong if I didn't give her a response. I missed you too, Carrie. But we should probably get going to school. Lifting my wrist slowly, my fingers tap against the smooth glass of my watch, captivating Carrie's amber eyes as they slowly widen in shock.
We're late? No, that can't be.
Hmm. See, I knew I was smart for that. I don't think she has ever been late before. Her reserved, timid nature couldn't possibly handle the harsh scolding that's usually bestowed upon typical delinquents. It'd be cruel, but awfully cute to watch. Imagine her scrunching her eyelids as if to tuck herself away like a deer caught in the headlights. As adorable as she'd be, there's no need to put her through that sort of torment. After all, I can appreciate her innocence anytime I please. Okay, me. She's standing right there. The girl I can't help but love. We should probably hurry then. Matching her skin with mine, in one swoop move, I clutch her hand tightly enough to cause the usual crimson glow to appear across her delicate cheeks. Fancy a run?
Again?
As cliche as it might be, I can't help but cherish the small things about our relationship. The things that really bring us together. With our duet ready to begin, our legs move in unison, ready to take on the challenge before us. Let's go! Up, up, and away. Let me chill. It's like I've come down in a couple of days. Stand off swiftly, I turn my neck to take another glance at the girl, whimsically running alongside me. Her hair, tussled by quick movements against the wind, still gracefully caresses her ever-endearing beauty. In a way, I guess I'm lucky for finding such a treasure.
Okay.
Feeling the wind gently swept across my face, my eyelids shift upwards, greeted by the vision of the school before us. Watching countless students flow through the door towards class, following their respective routines, it's enough to tell me we've made it on time. Slowing to a stop, still held my hand. Carrie takes a few resting breaths as her braids dangle over a slumped set of shoulders. I can't help but to join her.
We made it.
Just in time, too. In fact, I don't think we really that late to begin with. Judging by the number of students still easing their way through the gates. Regardless, being together with Carrie is enough to brighten my sour thoughts, even if I'm now considerably weakened.
Shall we go inside? It's cold.
Oh, you learns me, Carrie. You learns me. if y'all wondering why I said that, check episode 1. Anyway, as she clutches my hand tightly, each shiver from her warm body reaches across to mine. It's only October, but really has gotten a lot colder. Even after our faithful run, I can't keep up with her here for much longer. That's a good idea. Sorry, I had to drink. Strolling down now all too familiar corridors towards class with the girl I cherish still gripping my hand tightly. We arrive at the door, which signals our separation. It's funny to think that after arriving here just a month ago, things like this now seem fairly normal to me. Turning to face her, our eyes together peering towards one another, Carrie's blush still looms on her face from before as she looks back towards me with a shy yet alluring smile. Her lips glisten, sunlight streaming from the glass panes beside us meets them. She knows just well as I do that it's time to say goodbye. But really won't be long.
I'll see you later, okay?
Did you remember to bring your lunch money again?
Of course I did. I wouldn't want you to pay for me again.
Girl, did you not hear the beginning of, the opening for this? It's not like I wouldn't. Word. You don't have to worry about that. But anyway, I'll see you at lunch.
Okay.
Turn around in a frail manner, Carrie moves forward with her back to me. heading off to her own class. After not seeing her for the past week, knowing that this isn't a long goodbye is enough to warm my heart. And enough for me to realize that I've been standing in the corridor for far too long to be normal. I guess it's time to head inside. Sitting in my usual seat, the aura of the typical classroom chatting pans the space around me in the form of trivial conversations. The class always full of lethargy as we wait patiently for our teacher to arrive. What's the point of coming to class anyway in this day and age? What do you mean? I hate it too, but everyone has to come. Didn't you hear? This is this girl in the Northeast scoring highly on the national test. What's the point of dumbasses like us going to school when there's smart Tarsies like that around? Watch me get this wrong. To get a job. This is not what I want in my class either with attitudes like that. The class falls silent. Now we're the teacher's presence. Considering we have biology, I know this is going to be a long couple hours. Lunch couldn't come any sooner. Drawn to the end, the class resumes prior activity from the morning as conversations bounce around the room in preparation for lunch. All around me, people rise from their seats as crowds forms around the class door. It might take a while for me to get out, rather a couple seconds longer. However, the amount of time is still enough to cause irritation. Within me, my heart beats to see Carrie, to see that smile again. Greeted by the corridor, the repeated routine of joining the shifting mass of students towards the cafeteria plays on the usual fashion. Another insignificant, but somehow special part of my life. Each day moving forward with people which I could consider total strangers, heading towards the girl I love. And those sandwiches, and they're okay too, I guess. Standing in the line in the cafeteria, a quick glance around, despite being filled with a scene of lively students eating food, shows no sign of Carrie. Having agreed to meet here for simplicity, this is the first time we've actually been able to eat food, to get food together. It's not like I dislike waiting for her outside of class. Being able to see her cute face light up in surprise whenever she saw me, even though she knew I'd be there, was always a delight. However, cluttering up the corridors wasn't the best option, nor was getting pushed by people eager to get food. So here I am, feet placed sturdy on the ground, waiting for her, slowly inching forward as the line progressively gets shorter.
Ah, it's always a treat. Oh, it's always nice to treat yourself to lunch after a long weekend. It's a shame they don't sell those beef sandwiches anywhere else.
Oh my god, if you keep talking about those, like, it's no, like, it's like, why are they still popular?
Shoot, must be really that good.
I guess so. Shoot, 100% beef sandwiches are still popular. They're always in short supply. Can't you just, like, buy more than one and take them home?
Holy hell, man, you're a genius!
To join one of these clubs, they need a guy like you there.
Is this nigga serious? What he means by one of those clubs, I don't know. However, I sure do know that I'm nowhere near smart enough to top any leaderboards. Besides, who would want to spend their time at a club when walking home with Carrie is a much more enjoyable experience?
There you are. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Hey, looks like you got yourself some 100% Welsh beef there too, huh? Oh, hell nah.
All the being nudged on the arm, I'm not sure whether I want to punch him or laugh. Carrie trots up to my side, taking her place in the line for food too. Her glasses being slightly ajar on her face adds to an innocent and frail appearance. I can imagine her having ran here, not wanting to be late to join me. Brushing up against my side, her arm briskly skirts across mine, causing us to meet one another again. Lately, I've noticed her standing increasingly closer to me more than before. Maybe that's part of being in love. Or maybe it's her lack of self-awareness. No matter what it is, there'll always be one word to describe it. Cute.
Sorry about that.
It's okay, Curry. You just bruised me, that's all. It's funny to tease her. A bruise wouldn't even form this quickly.
Are you okay? Sorry.
I'm joking. Placing my hand gently upon her golden hair, Carrie moves her eyes towards upwards before going red in her characteristic manner of embarrassment.
Not here.
Yeah, man. We're at the front of the queue anyway. Save that lovey-dovey stuff for later. Oh my god, man. What did this do? And then, yeah, shoot, this makes me want to tell a false story time. Yeah, I got y'all one of these days. Yeah, that's, yo, I've had a moment like that. But yeah, I'm gonna sum it up. So basically, it's like, chill girl, whatever. Getting the makeout session on. The guy asks me some questions because I'm their dorm president. He asked me some questions and all that. And then she's just like, yeah, I think it's time for me to go. And if I could show y'all my face, it was like, I was so mad. But anyway, maybe it was a bit too forward, but she is my girlfriend after all. Lifting my hand away from Carrie, I turn to face the selection of goods available. Also, I didn't net out. Lifting my hand away from Carrie, I turn to face the selection of goods available on offer. It's probably better if we just got something and sat down. Following suit, Carrie grabs a lunch salad box from the counter and trails behind me, curving herself around the chairs of our fellow students. It's amusing to see how much consideration placed into her movements, particularly at the expense of people who did little so to help her. On the other hand, I'll be happy to bump into anyone if they're in my way. For real.
Shall we sit by here?
Still beside the explicitly empty table, tucked almost nearly out of sight, Carrie peers purely towards me with her golden eyes widening as she awaits a response. Sure, here's fine. Whether she wants to tuck herself away from everyone else, or whether she just wants to be, or whether she just wants a bit of privacy, I don't mind. For me, it's good to be alone with her, even in a room full of people.
Yo, is there space going on here, man? Oh my god, will you just go?
No hot water. I'm a pan fried noodle, this nigga. Scrape the pot when I'm through with this nigga. Smack. Who is this nigga? I'm Wikipedia, ask Jeeves, Google this nigga. Media takeout, world star hip hop, trying to find somebody that knew this nigga. I found a man pushing a shopping cart full of crushed cans. Selling the ironing board and the fan, gave me the scoop on this nigga. He said, Calico. Oh, Calico. Since that Detroit verse shot town, they've been through with this nigga. I got frustrated YouTubing this nigga. Cause every time I typed his name down, I kept getting the same search results. No matches found.
What does this dude just get away? Oh my god, yeah.
Say, I see you chose the sandwich too. Nice choice. Her? A salad? Well, it doesn't look like she can handle a lot of meat anyway.
No, there isn't space going. And I'm about to hook your
Damn, man, chill. I thought we were friends.
I don't even know your name, bro.
You don't need to.
Walking with a wink, he disappears off into the crowd at the expense of tables further along. Good thing he's gone.
What did he mean by...
Don't worry about it. Looking downwards, Carrie fiddles with her fingers as the table goes silent. It's only the two of us, which makes the entire thing even more awkward. She either wants to ask him, or something's wrong. Hopefully it's the former.
Are you doing anything after school?
Lucky me. Yes.
No, I'm pretty much always free. If I went home early, I'd have to face the wrath of my father prying his hands deep into my social life. That would be privy to another argument about totes.
Good. It'd be bad if you joined a club or something.
Oh, it's not like I can join a club anyway. Or rather, that I'd be interested.
Do you want...
Want to what?
Do you want to go on a date with me?
Blurring out the question, Carrie's face reddens almost instantly as she averts her eyes away. What does she expect me to say? It's not like I'd refuse. Of course I do. I will never tell you otherwise. You turn the gaze towards me, Carrie leaves her mouth ajar as she stalls for her own words. Seeing her like this is cute. Having really introduced myself to her in this very hall, it's almost nostalgic, despite us being together for the past month.
Thank you.
It's not something I need to be thanked for. And in the sentence, with a smile, Carrie lets out a small laugh in response, enough to make me fall in love all over again.
Then it's sorted. I'll be waiting for you. Okay.
I hope she will. Shoot, tucking into our salad, I join Carrie in the beginning of one of many lunches together, even if the break is closing in on its end. Being here with her, I couldn't be happier.
I'll be waiting here for you.
I leave beside the door to the class, once again Carrie and I face with the threat of separation. Yeah, I know I messed that up, y'all. After what we've been through, facing this sort of predicament is rather comical. She could be sitting around in class right now, 6,000 miles away, all positively fleeting from her body. Or rather, probably asleep, given the difference in time zone. The point stands, though. I'm honestly glad that she was able to stay. That we had the chance to tell each other our feelings. I love you, Carrie. You couldn't have forgotten, could you?
No, of course not. I love you too.
looking at me gently with a smile on her cheeks, as always stay a deep shade of rose, as she's graced by the afternoon sunlight. Each part of her delicate face is lit up by the essence of nature. It's picture. Oh my God. It's good.
See you later.
See ya. Drawn to an end, once again the class emits the very same sluggish aura with everyone just about finished for the day. Having transferred here not too long, it's a very unchanging aspect of school life I've become used to all over again. However, there's one thing which continues to surprise. A girl who continues to find a way to make me smile. Join the master students as always, I make my way out of class. With various students passing through my field of view, my eye spotted a faint glimpse of golden flowing braids down neatly with care, topping with two little red bows. It's not too hard to guess who the person is. Moreover, knowing she's here for me lightens my heart, even though it was to be expected. Making my way towards her, she lifts her hand to catch mine in view and sets up the same scenario out of habit. Amber eyes caught in surprise, matched by deeply reddened pair of cheeks with her mouth slightly ajar, trying to catch something to say. She's nervous and she's scary. Carrie?
Good morning.
It's 3:00 in the afternoon.
Right.
You okay? For whatever reason, she's acting weirder than normal. It's not like I dislike the awkward side of her. Rather, it's truly what makes her special to me. However, from time to time, there's enough of a reason to ask questions. Having blared out her emotions to me just under a month ago, seeing her shell herself up again like this is something strange.
I'm just nervous. Is all. You really make me happy.
Hearing those words, it's something reassuring. I love being securely founded, bonding us together. I have to admit, you always make me a little nervous. Carrie looks on, bemused by my words, stretching my arm out towards her. My fingers jolt her hair aside as I gently flick her on the forehead. Don't feel so bad about it. You make me happy too. Taking the first steps through the corridor with my feet meeting the polished floor below, I begin to make my way outside the school, now over for the day. Carrie, taking her cue, trails alongside me as we wander through the swaths of students heading outside together, a couple. Welcomed by a soft autumn breeze against our skin, Carrie and I stand beside the school gates in regular fashion. I don't know what that word is. I just don't know the exact meaning or how to pronunciate it. Her having somehow taken grasp of my hand whilst we were walking, being the first to speak up.
A date.
So what would you plan on doing? Seeing that you asked? It's not like I really care, man, or truthfully doing anything with her is enough to satisfy me. I'd be fine just standing here with her, our hands together, embraced by a warm afternoon sun against us.
Shall we go into town?
As expected, we're going to the city. Despite being a fun trip, I wish I had the chance to do more with her. Regardless, around here, there aren't really many opportunities for outings other than the city. Still, complaining isn't a good virtue. I have plenty of chances to spend time with her as life itself steams ahead. A summer trip will be fun if I'm patient to wait for it. Seeing her in a swimsuit would be nice.
Wow.
Zoning out is never a good idea. Yeah, that'd be great. Curling her lips up into a delicate smile, it's enough to make my own emotions flourish as a smile of my own. After meeting her, I've really become a different person. But it's the person I've always dreamt of being. With Carrie at my side, the pair of us stand and wander. Well, hold on 1 second, y'all. With Carrie at my side, the pair of us stand and wander at the world around us, people moving in each another direction, heading on with their daily lives. it shouldn't be surprising, but even for us, seeing so many people once in a place is still a bit of a shock. I mean, seeing so many people, oh my God. One day, maybe we'll be in their very positions moving forward together towards the future as our relationship continues to bloom. But still, two ordinary people to any passerby.
Well, we're here.
The situation we find ourselves in, too, isn't all too surprising either. Both of us at odds as to what we want to do together. An entire city around us, an entire world to explore. But still just as content standing here together as one. I'm glad this girl caught my heart. How about we go for a walk? The very same thing we did together just a few months ago that had brought us close. Casual walk. Walk through the city. Together. I could enjoy browsing the library just as much, window shopping, or even spending time at a cafe. Being with her though, having an opportunity to do something meaningful again is what I choose to do. To go back to that place at where we finally connected, where we told each other how we felt, and the world around us too?
Sure. I'd love that.
Taking my hand once again, Carrie looks upwards with the very same faint smile. My own reflection, crystal clear in her hazel eyes. When she looked at me, I wondered what she sees. For her, seeing her, the thing within my eyes is the person I've always been looking for.
Here we are.
Arriving beneath the very same set of trees, the very same view as before, the two of us stand amidst as statues while various couples walk on by together. I guess now we really do blend in with them. This place has always been known as a dating spot. Even now, that still holds true. Here I am with Carrie on a date. You're not going to confess to me again, are you?
What? You know, I
love you, Carrie. Please marry me. Oh, wow. Shoot, I'm jumping gun like that?
Isn't it a bit too early for that? We haven't even...
Let me chill. I was just practicing. Carried by a slight laugh, my teasing falls upon deaf ears. Carrie, oddly enough, still stands by my side with a stock look engraved upon her face by her features. Eyes directed towards the ground, lips firmly flat, almost frowning even. Still, against the passing autumn breeze, hair ruffling about as it gently strokes the skin of her cheeks, she reminds me almost motionless. A fragment of time. I'd be hard-pressed to find something that wasn't wrong in the scene before me. Are you sure you're alright? You've been acting a little weird all day.
It's just strange, you know? That so much has happened in the last month.
Really? I couldn't agree with her more.
You really mean a lot to me.
Peering once again towards me, Carrie's face carries a look of sincerity enough to pierce through my heart like a dagger. If I had any doubts, which I don't, one look at her would be more than enough to prove how she really feels. You mean a lot to me too, Carrie. I don't think you need me to tell you that. It'd be wrong if I didn't tell her that I feel the same.
But it's nice, isn't it?
She's right. Stuck by a long gust of wind, Carrie's braids sway almost diligently in the breeze, as if they were trying to make her look any more beautiful in this moment. Our date, almost looming to an end, despite us not really doing anything. But what we do was important to us. Staring at the sky above, I watch as the sun dawns closer towards the horizon. Going on a date straight after school really cuts down our time here. Coming here again would be nice. It's getting late. Almost at an instant, Carrie places her hand in mine once again and gently squeezes her warmth distinct against the cold autumn air.
We should head home then.
Despite finding herself flustered over those sort of things, it doesn't stop her from enjoying that feeling. The feeling of being close is something I can enjoy too. Oh. Alright, so with that, and we're back. Strolling down the street, the cool autumn air sends chills across me as I walk hand in hand with Carrie, returning home from our date. At times like these, it's really hard not to appreciate the wonders of life, the what-if scenario we truly love to come up with as people. What if Carrie didn't drop her library card on the way to school? What if I didn't leave for school early that day? What if she met someone else? It's hard not to find yourself depressed mulling over such topics. However, as we move along, I know heartily that things worked out in the end, for both of us.
Are you cold? Perhaps we should have dinner.
What were you thinking? I'd happily have some more of your dad's cooking.
Well, I want to see your house for a change.
Girl, I just want to take you back home. Straight to the crib. Give you that work. Oh, first verse. Let me check. Her girl lifts into a complacent grin. Carrie's smug side shines through her usually timid personality. For her, it's an innocent suggestion going to see her boyfriend's house. However, I'm privy to the world beyond those doors, and I know for a fact taking her there would not end well. With a distinct gulp, I brace every ounce of my body to respond to her in acquisition. It'd be mean to bluntly reject her offer, but there must be something I can do to stop us from going in that direction. You sure? My mom's not a good cook. That's a lie, but hopefully it'll throw her off the topic.
That's okay. I just wanted to see what it's like. Isn't that fine?
Damn. Yes, it's fine. In the end, with her cute expression held dead straight against my own eyes, I can't turn it down. Whatever happens, it's not my fault, right? All I have to do is introduce it to the family. It's not much of a problem. Is what I like to think, still. I was going to have faced this burden eventually. I can't keep my family hidden forever. It'd be rude to do so, despite how unique they are. I'll just have to call them. With a quick press on the screen, I lift my phone to my ear as Carrie watches on with a confused articulation made profound by her features. Why didn't I just call my mom, y'all? Oh, Lord. Quite possibly she's at odds as to why I'm so hesitant to get this over with, but she'll soon find out exactly why that is. Hello. Who is this? B. Unconventional, my father answers the phone bashfully. Your pops. Son, we've been wondering where you were. I just been out, man. In hindsight, I should have probably let someone know I would be coming home later than usual, but there's no fixing that anymore. Now with Carrie by my side, shivering slightly as she stands with the path of a typical autumn gust, getting this call over with is my top priority. Not just to get her out of the cold, but my father has a habit of dragging on conversations by asking unnecessary questions. Out where? Didn't I tell you? If you've been on dates, I want to know about it. In the background, my mother's muffled voice can just about be distinguished. It sounds as if she's scolding him. Anyway, your mother's dinner is almost ready, so be sure to get home quick.
There won't be any left if you don't get back. Oh my god, I really messed up that whole sentence. I wouldn't be surprised. My pops eat like Goku, yo. Like, would it be okay if I brought someone over? She normally cooks enough for the two of you. Do whatever you please, son. As long as it doesn't bother me. How he expects me to know what he be bothered by is just another oddity fitting of this man. No matter what, though, I can't change the fact that he's my father. At times, he isn't butting his way into my social life. I can really appreciate the upbringing he gave me. Nevertheless, bringing Carrie anywhere near him is likely to send him into a real frenzy. As reluctant as I am, I still have that very girl peering towards me with a typical sheepish gaze. Turning her down isn't an option. Alright, I'll be home soon. Hanging up in almost an instant, I return my phone to its usual home within my pocket and turn towards Carrie with an uneasy smile. I hope you like bangers and mash. Given that she's undoubtedly familiar with our British cuisine. Despite being Japanese, my father's androphilia inhibits us from eating any real native food.
That's fine. I'm glad that I'm allowed to come over.
Run her delicate hand over the strands of her silky hair, Carrie responds with an endearing smile. Maybe in the end, letting my family know of our relationship isn't such a bad idea. Having found a girl so perfect, I don't think my father would be disappointed. Even finding a girl alone would be enough to satisfy him. Hopefully he'll stop pestering me over the topic now that he can finally see who I've fallen for. Well, we should get going.
It's cold.
Yeah. It's cold. It's cold outside. As our feet tap against the floor, the pair of us embrace the warmth of my house, pacing through the door I've become so familiar with. Not so long ago, everything about my life had shifted around, moved and adjusted, having gotten so used to life here. Having arrived not so long ago, it's great that so much has happened in the time we've been here. It's great that I've found the life I'm happy with.
So, this is your house?
It might not be as fancy as hers, despite my father's earnings, but living anywhere else would no doubt feel strange. As humans, despite fearing change, we adapt to it ever so quickly. Yo! As almost if prompted, the sound of footsteps make themselves distinct from the living room. Well, here goes. Oblivious, Carrie stands and watches inquisitively as a broad man blocks her path. It's a shame she's playing the harp and not the flute. Son, you're back. And never in my life have I seen a man silent so suddenly, his eyes fixed towards Carrie as if he was staring right at the heart of an alien world. No ounce of expression remains on his typical emotive face. Whatever he's thinking, whatever happens next, it's not my responsibility. Son, I've never been more proud of you in my life. When's the wedding?
Wedding?
With a hearty laugh, he continues on with his inquisition, set off almost in a state of disbelief and euphoria. You sure have caught a nice catch, son. What's the fine girl's name?
Carrie. Short for Caridwin.
Oh, so it's Caridwin? I don't know how you say that middle part. That's the middle. Yeah, the middle of her name kills me. It's like Caridwin. Ah. Welsh, huh? I thought you didn't look Japanese. It's nice to meet you, Carrie. It's not like that fact wasn't obvious.
It's nice to meet you.
Darling, come here for a second. We have guests.
Despite being a renowned author, my father still groups me as one of those said guests, even though Carrie's the only one here. Emerging from the kitchen, my mother looks towards Carrie with a slightly milder sense of surprise than my father.
Welcome home, son. Looks like your father's words really have gotten to you, huh?
Smiling before it's taking her place next to my father, she looks onwards towards Carrie with a friendly smile.
It's nice to meet you.
Carrie.
Carrie, that's a beautiful name.
Thank you.
If her father was here, I'd expect him to comment something like, I chose it myself. But I'm honestly glad someone in my family can greet her like a normal person.
So, Carrie, what does your family do? Surely a girl like that has a wealthy background. She goes to that school after all.
My father? He's an engineer.
An engineer. I can respect that. What about your mother?
My mother?
Carrie falls on silent, save for her breathing. Her face is an expression I didn't think I'd ever see to have to see again. Her entire aura, how shifted by clouds of depression, her troubles coming back to haunt her. Unintentionally, my father stands there clueless as his gaze increases pressure upon us. I have to do something. She's an optician. Throwing out the first thing I can think of, hopefully it's enough to deflect the conversation. I can't let Carrie feel sad again.
Optician, you better be getting a good deal on those glasses, girl.
Carrie raises his head and a clear look of woeful still lingering in her eyes. Regardless of that, my father continues as if it's abnormal.
Well, I'll leave you two lovebirds at it. Who knows, maybe one day she'll actually be your girlfriend.
I am his girlfriend.
Letting the cat out of the bag, my father looks on towards Carrie with the same expressionless stare before turning to another brass smile.
Son, I'm glad I didn't wear one.
What? Oh, okay. I got it.
He said, you can't possibly say that to him.
What? He knows it's a joke.
As the pair walk off the kitchen and gaze in another session of my family banter, Carrie and I are left alone in the hallway, together silent. Well, those were my parents. Are you okay? Delving back into the topic of her mother is not something either of us really want, but I can't leave her alone in a saddened state. I can't let her continue to bear those burdens.
It's fine. Thank you for clearing it up.
Raising her head to line her eyes with mine, Carrie catches me once again in her trance. Cheeks red and she puffs them up once she takes notice of me.
You like looking at me, don't you?
Can't help it. That's your fault. She responds with a warm, cute giggle.
Anyway, I think it's time for me to see your room and just how messy it really is.
Leaving me with a smug grin, Carrie boldly makes her way past towards me to the staircase.
Yo, hey!
It's almost reminiscent following her very footsteps up the flight of stairs now that she's here before me, and not sitting in some field 6,000 miles west of here, I can really be content with the scene before me. knowing that we found one another. See, it's not that messy after all. Idling within my room, I watch on as Carrie stands motionless, taking in the environment around her. The evening light embraces her skin as she stands facing towards the world outside. A world moving right before her eyes, yet she still stands there, motionless. Remaining rather distant, a small sigh escapes her mouth, enough to tell me that something's wrong. Throughout the day, glimpses of Carrie's own feelings have breached out, manifested themselves. Should have known sooner. It's unlike her to be blatant about her feelings. Carrie.
I don't deserve this. I don't.
Carrie, please, what's wrong?
It's just unreal. There isn't anything special about me.
Turn around, Carrie's body now faces towards me, her face coated in a familiar sense of woe. A feeling I never want to feel again, rising up from inside.
Nobody has ever been nice to me before, all my life. My mother, my classmates, I've never known anything different. Please, just tell me the truth.
Lifting her head, Carrie looks deep within my eyes, teardrops welling up against the amber within hers. Seeing her like this, knowing what she's been through, can't blame her. For me, the past month has felt like a dream. I even tried pinching myself just to be sure, but there's no doubt in it. Right now, I'm in a relationship with her, as if we were made for each other. As cliche as it might be, I don't think I'd ever be happy with anyone else. That's why I can't let it all fall down. If she wants the truth, then I'll happily give it to her. I wasn't lying when I told you that you were important, Carrie. Just over a month ago, we were in this very same situation. Carrie before me, lost in a world of darkness. I want to be a light, as much as she's been mine. Over and over, I tell myself how important Carrie has been to me. Moving here, lost in a new world, Carrie pulled me out of that. I once again thought to be a dead end. She gave me a chance to change myself. Whether you think you deserve it or not, none of that matters to me. What matters is right here, right now. Placing my finger upon my chest, Carrie directs her eyes towards the very essence of love itself. The heart. It's like, I love you, Carrie. Nothing's going to change that. What was to be special to me, no matter what. She lifts her head once more, now with a look of relief in her eyes. With the all hardships this girl has faced, knowing that we can overcome them together is an indescribable feeling. Like love, but better. But there can't be anything better than that.
I'm sorry. But being with you makes me happy. I really love you.
Making her way over to me, Carrie wraps her arms around me tightly, as if she never wants to let go. The smooth skin of her cheeks brushing gently against my cheek. There couldn't be anything more sincere. She finishes nuzzling against my sweater. Carrie wipes the teardrops out of her eyes. Even with the reddened eyes and damp cheeks, she still can't be described with any other world other than beautiful. Or at least something along those lines. You really are silly, you know. Ruffling the hair upon her head, Carrie pouts as she quickly regains her composure. This heartwarming feeling, having been through bullying, bearing witness to an unstable marriage, having been left lonely by the world, a life like that can't be easy to accept. Nevertheless, I'll do whatever it takes to make her happy, to see her smile. Final orders, my eyes close tightly as the world before me disappears. It's strange. We function by receiving inputs from the world around us.
responses, if you will. Having completely blocked the space around me from sight, each breath Carrie and I take, each feeling against our skin, every sense becomes even more important. Something warm, something moist, lands upon my cheek. She really did it, didn't she? As I lift open my eyes, before me stands the girl, adorned in a tan sweater, her silky hair done neatly into the two braids resting over her shoulders. This girl stands here, complacent, with her lips curled up into an adorable smile. No matter how I look at it, this is the girl I've fallen in love with. Whatever could have happened is none of our concern. It's a world now behind us. What really matters is our feelings. And at the end of the day, it's clear that we both feel the same.
Let's always stay together.
Wait, that's really it? Yep. Shoot, that's it, yeah. Alright, so yeah. Glad y'all, hope y'all enjoyed the playthrough.
It's pronounced Carrie, like a K.
So yeah, with that, I'll catch y'all. Love y'all. Peace.
Let me fuck you on the couch while your friend watching. She wanna join us, but she can't, cause her man calling. Got you pulling on my chain like I'm the man or something. You ever fucked and imagine what tonight you bout to? Hit that pussy till your legs shake. Jacuzzi bubbles on your ass, don't get your hair wet. Love your pretty titties and your assets. And when you bite your lip and make your sex face.